move on to discuss oral contraception, which are two forms, combined oral contraceptives, which consist of estrogen and progestin, and the progestin-only pills, which consist of a progestin only. Okay? You need to make a group. هلا انتو شو بدكم تفتر على عشرة صح؟
شرط الوقت؟
لا 12
تكوني ليدر؟
بدك
ليدر؟ مش فارقة بس انا ما اللي بدها ليدر تكتب اسمها اول
She wants to delay pregnancy for several years, more than 1 year. These data are very important in order to select a contraception for your patients.
No, no, we are.
For the group A, please.
Oh, great.
Okay. Now, we mentioned that our patient has an irregular menses. We consider a female cycle to be irregular if the difference between the shortest and longest cycle is 10 days or more. Now, your patient's longest duration is 36 days and the shortest one is 25, so the difference is 11 days. So, your patient has irregular menses. And they are prolonged because to be normal, it should be 8 days or less. Now your patient is duration of menstrual flow is 8 to 10 days. So your patient's menses are prolonged and irregular. She denies heaviness. She mentioned that her last period was 2 weeks ago. So she is in day
15.
Almost. Now the normal cycle, female reproductive cycle, consists, the ideal cycle consists of 28 days. Day 1 is the onset of menses and day 28 or the last day of the cycle is the day before the next blood flow. Okay? So your patient mentioned that her period started 2 weeks ago. 2 weeks ago mean 14 days, so she is in day 15. This will affect using a backup method with the current method if your patient was in certain day of her cycle. Okay? So our patient is in day 15. Now, there's an important point. You have, before initiating any contraceptive method, to exclude the pregnancy. So, did your patient ovulate? Is it possible to get pregnant?
Mm-hmm.
How we know? Now, usually ovulation occurs 14 days before the onset of the next cycle. Okay? Now, usually we say 28 minus 14. This will be the ovulation day, 14. Now, our patient cycles is not 28. It's arranged from 36. Now, we will use the shortest duration to calculate the ovulation day. The shortest duration is 25, not the 36. So 25 minus 14, she will ovulate on day 11. Now, today she is in day 15, so it's possibly that your patient already ovulated. So if she had an unprotected sex, the chance of pregnancy is possible. Okay, so we should consider this when we select a contraceptive. Any question till now? Now, your patient is a known case of migraine headache without aura. Now, certain each contraceptive method has its contraindication, or any patient will be eligible or ineligible for certain contraceptive method based on its contraindication. Your patient has migraine headache without aura, which is well controlled over the past year by using propranolol. She has a positive family history of osteoporosis and breast cancer. She used alcohol socially. Her home drugs are propranolol for migraine prevention and naproxen BIN for dysmenorrhea. She has mild dysmenorrhea. She is nulliparous. This means that she did not give a birth for a baby before. Okay. She denies excessive vaginal bleeding, so she has no heaviness. The menstrual cycle are most irregular during final exam and midterm. She did not have any impact over the past year. She has migraine related to menstruation and migraine without menstruation. This is before starting the high blood pressure is 108/68. Is she hypotensive? Did I recommend a hypotension?
Yes.
Yes.
No.
No.
We don't consider blood pressure that is less than 120/80 to be hypotension unless your patient is symptomatic. And we will look to the heart rate. It should be increased reflex tachycardia. Or your patient have symptoms of hypotension, or the blood pressure is very low, 90 for example, the systolic blood pressure. So your patient has no hypertension, she has normal blood pressure. The heart rate is 66 because she is on propranolol. She is using a beta blocker. She has mild non-inflammatory facial acne. Some contraceptive method may affect acne by either improving or get worse. Her uterus is normal, anti-birthed. The shape of the uterus will affect if you will use intrauterine device or not. Here we will not discuss intrauterine device, only oral contraception. So the assessment, your patient is here today asking for a contraceptive method. She asked about using a hormonal contraceptive that will decrease her number of periods. So if that's possible, we should do that for your patient. She has irregular menstruation. Some contraceptive method will regulate menses. This is called a non-contraceptive benefit of a contraceptive method. So try to get benefit for your patient. Try to get benefit on acne too. The migraine headache is well controlled. So should we continue with propranolol for this patient? This is case one for group A. Now, case two for group B, your patient is a 36-year-old female. She presents also to the clinic for contraception counseling. She is using male condom previously. She wants to have a child in a year or so. She had a history of depression, treated by sertraline for 6 months. Now she is not using sertraline. She has hypertension on hydrochlorothiazide and ramipril, which was started 6 weeks ago. Yeah. Your patient is complaining of nagging cough, dry cough, started 2 weeks ago. Now we don't have any data about patient cycle, if it's regular or in which day she is. So consider your patient menses regular. She have a normal menstrual flow, no heaviness, and she have the ideal cycle, 28 days. Okay. She is a smoker, half bag per day, and she would like to quit. Can we recommend certain medication for smoke cessation in this patient?
Yes.
In addition to non-pharmacologic management. Now, the medication, hydrochlorothiazide and ramipril for hypertension, ibuprofen, BIN for dysmenorrhea, and dextromethorphan with guaifenesin for cough, dry cough. Now, the cough is possibly related to?
Ramipril
use. So what's your plan with ramipril? She is obese. Now, some contraception methods are less effective in obese patients. So consider that when you are choosing a contraceptive. High blood pressure is controlled. The goal of blood pressure is less than 140 over 90, so she is controlled. Now the lactates are normal. So we need to choose an oral contraceptive, either combined oral contraceptive or progestin only pill for our patient. We should decide when this contraceptive should be started in regard to menstrual cycle, day 1 to day 28. We should decide if we should use a backup method, condom, for certain period after initiation of your method. You should specify the dose of the contraceptive, the name of the contraceptive, the progestin, and the estrogen. Okay. Now you may read from oral contraceptives, from Dynamed, or from UpToDate. You will get the same information. And before you start, you should know that when we select certain contraceptive method, we should think about many things. The first thing is the method contraindicated or the eligibility criteria for contraception. When the patient wants to get pregnant, return to fertility, certain method will delay return to fertility, while other just directly after discontinuation, the patient will be fertile again. The effect of menses, the non-contraceptive benefit that can be achieved from certain method for your patient, and the patient's preference. For example, in the first case, the patient wants to decrease her number of menses. If the patient wants pills and refuses intrauterine device, we can use it. We can't force patient to choose certain method unless the method she chooses is contraindicated. Okay? So let's start. Open your e-learning, please. Give me back the blue paper. Now, group A, please fill your answer from DEMA on DEMA e-learning. Case 1, you will open case 1 report. And the group B from Tiba, open report for case 2. Okay? Start. You have 40 minutes. You will first answer a certain question from question 1 to 12. These are multiple answers or MCQs. You can choose more than one answer. Don't select randomly. You have to be sure. If you are not sure, don't put that answer because it will decrease your grade. Now, the last question is to fill the plan sheet. It's out of 3. 3 out of 15. Okay? It will be corrected manually later on. Again, رح تجاوبوا الأسئلة من 1 ل 12 MCQ. ممكن تختار أكثر من إجابة. بتختار تكتب الإجابة الصحيحة بس اللي أنت متأكد منها، مش تروح تحط لي إياهم كلهم. إذا بتعبي كل الخيارات تاخذ صفر، بتحط واحد صح وواحد غلط تاخذ صفر، يعني حسب عدد الإجابات الصحيحة. مثلا في عندي 4 صحيحات و4 خطأ، إذا أنت جاوبت الأربعة الصحيحات حطيت معهم 2 خطأ بتاخذ نص العلامة، فأنت بتجاوب الإشي الصح بس اللي متأكد منه. آخر سؤال هو البلان شيت، رح تعبوها على الإي ليرنينج، رح تلاقوا إنه في عنا تيبل رح تعبوا فيه ملخص، يعني أنتوا أوريدي بتكونوا جاوبتوا الكيس بالأسئلة، بعدين بتلخصوا. Yeah. go ahead. You have 40 minutes after you start your report. Your dog's report will be. Now our patient is a 24 year old. She is sexually active. She wants to delay pregnancy for several years because she is a student for than 1 year. She has irregular menses, prolonged menses. She wants to decrease her number of periods, and she has mild facial acne. She is today in day 15 of her cycle, and she is possibly ovulated based on the shortest cycle, 25 days. Okay. Now we have many contraceptive methods, not only the oral contraceptives. The patient could be eligible for any other method. Okay. We will not discuss them. This table will compare the different methods in regard to advantage, disadvantage, and etc. You can read it yourself. We will repeat it again in menstrual related disorder. Now, the first thing that we should consider before selecting a contraceptive method is the eligibility. Is your patient eligible for certain method? Now, we have four categories. From 1 to 4. Category 4 is contraindicated. Don't use that drug. The risk is more than the benefit. Now, category 3, the risk is still more than benefit. So, we don't use it too. So, any category 3 or 4, we don't use that contraceptive method for your patient. 1 and 2, your patient is eligible for that method. All methods are categorized to 1, 2, 3, or 4. Okay? Now, you are only need to know the eligibility criteria for BOPs and combined hormonal contraceptive, for example. Okay? مطلوب منكم تعرفوا eligibility criteria للBOPs will combine اللي هم الأورال contraceptive. You need to know 3 and 4 only. 1 and 2 by exclusion. So you have to know for BOPs and combined hormonal contraceptive the contraindication when we can't use them. We will go through this table on the points that we already need to know in our patient only. Okay? Now the age. There is no exclusion over the age. You can use combined or a contraceptive or BOPs at any age. Your patient in the case 2 was 36. Being more than 35 will not prevent using hormonal contraceptive. Okay? Now, depressive disorder also, we see here that you can use combined oral contraceptive and progesterone only pills in depression in the second case. It's not a contraindication. Regarding headache, in the first case, your patient was a known case of migraine headache without aura. Now, if your patient has aura, it's contraindication, category 4. If it was without aura, you can initiate, but you can't continue after the age 35. Okay? So, in case 1, our patient was 24. You can start combined. But at age 35, you should switch to another method. You can't use combined hormonal contraceptive. Okay? Now, regarding menstrual-related headache, if it was migraine-related only to menses, the same. If it was with aura, you can't use it. If it was without aura, you can use, and it may improve migraine related to menstruation instead of prophylactic medication. So our patient in the case 1 is eligible for using both progesterone only pills and combined oral contraceptive. Regarding hypertension in case 2, is hypertension makes using progesterone only pills or combined oral contraceptive contraindication? Is it eligible to use combined in hypertension?
No.
We don't use combined in hypertension even if it was controlled. Okay? Now, the multiple cardiovascular patient have three or more cardiovascular risk, we don't use combined. Okay? Like hypertension, is a risk factor, obesity, smoking, family history of premature cardiovascular death, dyslipidemia, these are all a cardiovascular risk. So in case two, your patient is not eligible for using combined, but she can use progestin only. Now, obesity, you can use what? Combined and progestin only pills in obese patients. It will not increase the thrombotic event, okay? And their activity as other population. Only the emergency pills has reduced efficacy in case of obesity, okay? Again, كل contraceptive methods بالobese patient are effective. مين اللي بتنقص الإفكاسية تبعته؟ بس الإمرجنسي بيلز. يعني الإمرجنسي contraceptive بيلز ممكن يكون الإفكاسية تبعها بالobese patient أقل من الجنرال population. Okay. Now regarding parity, can we use oral contraceptive in a patient who is nulliparous؟ هل إنه البيشنت إذا ها مش مخلفي سابقا ممنوع تستخدم combined or box؟
عادي.
It's not a contraindication. She can use it. It will not affect fertility. Okay, this is a common mistake in community. Smoking, in second case, if your patient is a smoker at any age and she smokes more than 15 cigarettes per day, it's contraindicated. And if it is any number, but the age is more than 35, she can't use combined. She can use both. Okay? So the second case is another cause that we should not use combined. Okay? So in case one, we decided that our patient is eligible for both and combined. And in case two, we decided that our patient is only eligible for both. She can't use combined. Okay? Contraceptive benefits that can be achieved for the first patient from using combined are
reduction of dysmenorrhea.
Yeah, reduction of dysmenorrhea is a benefit for both POPs and combined. Reduction of acne, mild to moderate acne, is a benefit for certain combined with progestin. That it has low androgenic side effect. Regulation of menses for combined. The most common side effect for POPs are the erratic bleeding pattern. So your patient may get amenorrhea, may get spotting, frequent menses. So POPs are not recommended for a patient with irregular menses. So our patient in the first case, if she used combined oral contraceptive, she will have benefit on dysmenorrhea. She has benefit on acne and regulation of menses. Okay. Now, which contraceptive can be used in acne? For the first case. Can you use any combined for improvement of acne? Now, in combined oral contraceptive, the estrogen is the same. It's ethinyl estradiol. The progestin are different. The progestin differ from each other by their androgenic side effects. Okay? Now, if you use progestin with low androgenic side effects, it will improve acne. The FDA approved for management of acne, moderate acne, are an ethinyl estradiol combined with either norgestimate, norethinidrone, or drospirenone. So if you choose any of them, they are correct. Now we have Dayan in our market, which contain tiron. The indication of this drug is not a contraception. Even it will act as a contraceptive if it was used. The indication is severe acne management. Okay? It should be used only until improvement of acne. Then you have to discontinue it. You can't continue it as a contraceptive because of the increased risk of thrombotic event. So in pharmacies, Dayan should not be dispensed as a contraceptive. Again, التركيبة اللي فيها سبروتيرون مع كنيل استراديول هي صح تشتغل as a contraception بس احنا ما نستخدمها for contraception purposes. نعطيها لسيبير أكني اللي ما استجابوا للأذري تريتمنت، نعطيها بس لفترة قصيرة 3 إلى 4 شهور، بعدين لازم يتوقف. later on إذا رجع السيبير أكني again بيرجعوه لفترة قصيرة وبيرجعوا later on بيوقف. We don't use it for a year, for example, for management of, or for the purposes of contraception. So this option was wrong. Okay. Now you have to know that drospirenone, despite its advantage in reduction of side effects, it has a disadvantage of increasing potassium level in the blood. So it's contraindicated in case of chronic kidney disease. We already discussed this point in the last semester. Okay? ما بنعطي drospirenone containing contraceptive لوحدة عندها chronic kidney disease لأنه رح يزيد risk of hyperkalemia. Now regarding return to fertility, if you use combined oral contraceptive, the patient can continue using it as much as she wishes. Once she wants to get pregnant, she will discontinue it. Now, 90% of female will get pregnant within the first year. Okay? And this is applicable for all contraceptive method except the DBOT, progestin, DIMBA. It needs to achieve the 90% pregnancy in 18 months instead of 1 year. Okay? So your patient, regarding return to fertility, can use combined oral contraceptive and the same for progestin only does in the second phase. Now, we should think when we should start the combined oral contraceptive in the first case. Your patient in day 15. Can she start it today? متى بنبلش استخدام combined oral contraceptive or the progestin only does? In regard to female cycle, anytime. You can start it anytime. Some physicians will prefer to use it on the day 1 of menstruation, other within the first 5 days, the next Saturday. The best option or the best method is the quick start method, which means that the patient will start the method today, at the day she attend the clinic. Once you exclude the pregnancy, okay, and use a backup method for the recommended period for each method, you can start it. This is called the quick start method. So anytime, whether it was combined or progestin or any method, even intrauterine device. Now we have to exclude the pregnancy. Let's talk about the first case. Now the patient should do urine pregnancy test. If it was positive, then she is pregnant. If it's negative, can we certainly be sure that your patient is not pregnant? يعني إحنا طلع معنا اليوم فحص على يوم 15 طلع معي نيجاتيف. متأكدين إنها حامل أو لا؟
لا.
If she ovulated at day 11. It's impossible to have a positive urine test, pregnancy test today. At least she should repeat it later on after 2 weeks from now. Okay? If she had unprotected sexual activity. Now, our patient on day 15, it's possible that she ovulates. If we started the method today, should delay the using combined oral contraceptive for day one phoenix cycle. Again, يعني احنا افترضنا ان اليوم البيشنت ممكن تكون ovulated, يعني في احتمال ان تكون حامل بس ما بيبين معي. بصير ابلش combined oral contraceptive اليوم ولا اجله ليوم واحد the next cycle؟ شو انتو عملتو؟ case one, what was your choice?
لا صراحة احنا ما كملنا, ما لحقنا, الوقت كان كتير قليل. وصلنا يمكن السؤال 7 أو 8 ما لحقناش.
Okay. Now, we will go through this algorithm. Now our patient is here, in case one. The question suppose that she had sexual activity 6 days ago, more than 5 days. The pregnant day of the pregnancy test was negative, but it's not conclusive. Hormonal contraceptive can be started, will not harm the baby, but she must do a pregnancy test again after 2 months. If it was positive, she will discontinue them. Okay? Again, if you used hormonal contraceptive and the patient was pregnant, it will not harm the baby. Once she knows that she is pregnant, she will discontinue them. Whether it was progesterone only pills or combined oral contraceptive. Okay? So you can start it today. There's some point that if it was available in your patient, you will be sure that she is not pregnant. For example, if she did not have a sexual activity since day one, or if she was within the first 7 days of her menstrual cycle, or if she was using a reliable contraceptive pill before today. Okay? This point will exclude pregnancy. Let's suppose that in case one, we will start them for today, on day 15. Should we use a backup method? The backup method should be non-hormonal, for example, condoms, or abstain from sexual activity. The only methods that will act directly as a contraceptive after initiation is the Kabel intrauterine device and the levonorgestrel intrauterine device 52. Okay? Other methods need time to act. Again, ما في ولا أي contraceptive method تشتغل مباشرة من أول ما أبلش إلا 2 methods اللي هم الكبر انتريترين ديفايس والليفونارجسترين انتريترين ديفايس العيار 52. بقية الميثود ما بتشتغل دايركت, يعني إذا المريضة اليوم أخذت البيل وصار unprotected sexual activity ممكن تحمل إذا ما استخدمنا backup method. So backup method is needed for other methods that will not act directly, like the implant, the injectable, combined oral contraceptive, and progesterone only pill. If the method was started here after day 5 of her cycle, she is today in day 15, more than 5. So a backup method should be used for 7 days of initiating the contraceptive. Okay? In case 2, she used a traditional progesterone only pill, she was within the first 5 days of menstruation, she need no backup method. But if she was after the day 5, she need a backup method for 2 days. This is for traditional herbs. Okay? So in case 1, if you started it today, you need a backup method for 7 days. This is a combined oral contraceptive pill. Now let's talk about dosing regimen. For combined, the patient will use 1 pill each day for a 21 consecutive days, followed by 7-day pill-free period. Again, كيف ينعطى الكونترسبشن؟ نعطي الحبة باليوم لمدة 21 يوم متتابعية, بعدين تأخذ 7 أيام بالفري بيريود, يعني ما بتاخذ فيهم حبوب, او البنز اللي بتاخذهم اذا كان الباكيت 28 حبه بيكونوا فاضيين, يعني فيهم حديد, فيهم فرس, followed by 7 days pill-free period. Now, this will regulate the menses, because once the patient in the 21 days, she will expect to have menses in 1 to 2 days. And once she restarts the next cycle, the menstruation will cease, okay? So this is a regulation. She will expect the withdrawal bleeding. Here we will not call it menses, we call it withdrawal bleeding, because when you withdraw the hormone, the bleeding will occur. Okay? There's no ovulation with combined oral contraceptive. Now, how will we will decrease the number of menses for the first case? Can we get numbers and number of menses? She at the bottom of numbers and number of menses. We call it extended cycle. Extended means that you will extend active periods for more than 21 days for any period that change. For example, 2 back together, then 7 day free, 3 back, then 7 day free, 4 back, then 7 day free, as she wish. This is extended. You can just tell your patient that she can skip the 7 day placebo. And she was 21, then 21, then 21. After she end 3 back, for example, or 4 back, she will take 7 day last, or 7 day treatment, she will menstruate. So by this, you will regulate, and you will decrease the number of cycles. And this is the recommended for the first case, because she was pushed out. This is an example of Lizzie monograph of combined oral contraceptives. Check it yourself. Now, regarding missing pill with combined oral contraceptive, if she missed one pill or delayed for 1 day only, she will take the pill once she remembered. Then she will continue as usual. If she delayed 2 pills or missed 2 pills, then, in addition to administration of 2 pills at the first day, she will discard other pills. She will use a backup method for 2 days. Okay? No, sorry, for 7 days for combined, 2 days for both. Again, if the patient missed 1 pill, she will administer it and continue as usual. No need for backup method. If she missed more than 2 or more, or she delayed more than 2 days, she will administer only 1 pill of the missed pills and discard other, and she will use a backup method for 7 days. If the missing pill was at the 3rd week, she should skip the 7 day class and start the next cycle directly. In detail, they are written here. You can check them later. This is only for combined. Now, in the first case, the patient was controlled for migraine for a long time. So, what's our plan should be? For how long prophylactic medication should be used for migraine? Should she continue propranolol indefinitely? Once migraine are controlled for 6 to 12 months, you can try to discontinue the prophylactic regimen by tapering and monitor migraine frequency. You may get rid of the drug. The patient will still control even if we discontinue the prophylactic. In some patients, migraine frequency will increase again. So we will re-initiate the drug at the lowest effective dose. Okay? Again, يعني احنا دائما بس البيشنت اللي ماشي على البروفلاكتيك ريجيم شو ما كان صار كنترول لمدة 6 إلى 12 شهر، شو بنعمل؟ بنبلش تيبرينج للدرج، بنراقب المجرين. إذا رجعوا الفريكونسي زادوا، بنرجع الدوز اللي كان عليها ما في عنا ميجرين، يعني ممكن تكون اقل من الدوز اللي كان ماشي عليه. اذا ما رجعوا الميجرين خلص بنوقفوا، بيضلوا البيشنت كنترول ليتر اون. So in this patient we will try to taper propranolol because she is controlled for long time, and we will initiate combined. Combined will reduce the migraine related commensals, and this will help in controlling her migraine if it's restarted again. Any question in case one? Now let's see case two. She is a 36-year-old female. She has hypertension. She is a smoker, obese. She has multiple cardiovascular risks. And want a contraceptive pill. She is not eligible for combined, so we will initiate progestin only pills. We have two types of the progestin only pills: the traditional POPs and the desogestrel pills. Now the traditional POPs. Norethinidrone, for example, levonorgestrel, they will not inhibit ovulation. They will act on the mucus thinning. So ovulation only will be inhibited with desogestrel. It's somewhat similar to combined. Now the safety window for traditional POPs is only 3 hours. But the safety window for desogestrel is 12 hours. So we prefer to use desogestrel. On typical use, it will be more effective. Okay? So if your patient delay both the traditional box more than 3 hours from usual administration time, she should use a backup method for 2 days. Now, if she delayed desogestrel pills more than 12 hours from its usual time, she will use a backup method for 7 days because it's after ovulation, not on thinning. We can enter the mucus secretion. Okay? This is the difference between desogestrel and the traditional box. In patient, in the second case, you can use either traditional or desogestrel. We will prepare desogestrel because of its efficacy and prolonged safety window for percutaneous deaths. Okay? The most adverse effect with box will be the irritable bleeding. When it turns to fertility, will be direct with the traditional box. But in desogestrel, it needs around 17 days. The average is 7 to 30. Okay. This is the monograph of desogestrel. Now we have to note that desogestrel should be started at day one, not any time. Okay? Desogestrel should be started at day one without a backup method. If it was started from day 2 to 5, it's okay. But she should use a backup method for 7 days. We don't start it after day 5. She must stay using condom until the next cycle. Okay? But the traditional pill can be started anytime, as combined or contraceptive. Now, regarding the missing pill with desogestrel, the missed pill should be skipped. We don't administer 2 desogestrel pills at a day. Okay? But in traditional box, you can administer the missed pill. Okay? Any question? Now regarding the cough, or before cough, nicotine replacement therapy. Your patient wants to quit smoking. Should we use nicotine replacement therapy or varenicline or bupropion? What's the best option for your patient? لا، هذول first line medication. for smoke cessation, the first line indication are combined nicotine replacement therapy or varenicline or bupivacaine. Our patient has a history of depression and she has multiple cardiovascular disease, hypertension. We don't prefer to use nicotine replacement therapy in a patient with increased cardiovascular risk because it will worsening or increase the cardiovascular event. So we don't prefer nicotine. We prefer bupropion,
yes,
taking in consideration that our patient has a history of depression and she will benefit from using bupropion in addition to smoke cessation on depression. Okay? Now regarding the cough, you have to discontinue
ramipril.
We will not initiate another ACE inhibitor because it's a class side effect. All ACE inhibitors will induce cough. We will use another antihypertensive medication. In this patient, because she wants to get pregnant in a year or so, you don't need to use ARBs. She has no compelling indication for their use. You can just go directly to calcium channel blocker, which are first line in the treatment of hypertension during pregnancy. For example, nifedipine, extended release. Okay? We will discontinue cough medication to monitor the cough. If it is resolved, then it's related to ACE inhibitor. It should resolve in 2 weeks, for example, but in some cases it will continue for several months. But at the end, it will resolve. Okay? If it was not resolved, then it's not related to ramipril.